guys, well, this video is going to be a little bit different. Every time that I use the X-Carve, I get told multiple times in the comments that you can make anything if you have a $2,000 CNC machine. So in this video, I'm going to make a party serving tray, and I'm going to make it twice. I'm going to make it once by hand with hand tools and using the bandsaw and the router, and then I'm going to make the second one on the X-Carve. And so I've made two versions of the plans. One is in SketchUp, and that will be the one that we use for the handmade one. Not that we can really call it hand when we're using power tools, but you get the idea. The second one I have made in Adobe Illustrator, and this will go in the X-Carve as an SVG file, and we'll import that into Easel. And then using the SketchUp version, I made a template out of MDF, and this is what we'll use to route all of the edges and make all the cups in the tray when we use the router to make it. And so we're gonna start by making a couple of blanks, and we're gonna make those just like we're making long grain cutting boards. And so I'll make a big long one, I'll run it through the planer a couple of times, get it smooth, we'll cut it in half, and then we'll have our two blanks. So let's get started. Okay, well, we could just stop here and we would have some really cool long grain walnut and maple cutting boards. Just a little bit of finish and a little sanding and they would be beautiful. But we're not gonna stop there, we're going to turn these into serving trays. And to do that, again, we're gonna make one on the X-Carve and one with hand tools. And so I'm going to use this template and I'm going to use fabric tape to connect it. And then I'm going to use the fabric tape on the bottom to hold it to the workbench so that I can hog it out with the router and a guide bearing. For the CNC version, I'll do the same thing. I'll put the fabric tape on the bottom of it to hold it down to the bed of the X-Carve while it does the work. Okay, so I have the router set up with a guide bushing installed, and that bushing will ride along the edges of this template. So I've got the depth wheel set up so that I can turn it, and every time I turn it, I will cut an eighth inch deeper. So I can turn it, plunge, and that will allow me to slowly hog out all this material rather than trying to do it all at once. All right, well, this project did not turn out at all like I expected. I originally went into it thinking one thing, and the exact opposite actually happened. So let's first talk about the one that I made by hand. And so this is it here. I finished it with General Finish's salad bowl finish, which is a food safe finish. I'll probably add a couple more coats to it over the next couple of days and hit it with some steel wool and really make it look nice. I have roughly 2 hours invested in the making of this, and that includes making the template that I cut out on the scroll saw from a paper template. And so I'm actually kind of surprised at how well this turned out. It's very smooth, and it really turned out nice. So what about the one that I made on the X-Carve? Well, I never finished it, and here it is. And so let's talk about what happened. So number one, apparently the homing sequence did not work. So the homing sequence started right here, but as you can tell, the entire bowl is shifted up about a half of an inch, which means it ran out of room on this end. Now I figured that out about halfway through the carve because it was making these one at a time. So I decided, you know, hey, I'm gonna go ahead and let it finish because I can go ahead and just glue on another piece of maple and then put it back on and cut out the outside. Well, so then, roughly, 75-85% of the way through the cut, the belt slipped. And when that happened, it was cutting the circle in the center. And that shifted the entire circle off about an eighth of an inch. And so I said, well, I'm going to go ahead and let it finish that too, because I'm going to run this experiment all the way to completion. Well, as it was cutting out some of the last cuts, the DeWalt overheated. And it overheated and started smoking, and the bit actually came loose and fell out of the collet and drilled a hole all the way through my plank and through the bed of the X-Carve. So anyway, that is complete junk. And not only is it complete junk, I want to say one other thing, and that is, it took the X-Carve 7.5 hours to carve this. And that is after I originally estimated it at 13 hours, and I went in and I doubled the feed rate, thinking that with the DeWalt and the better bit that I had purchased, I could go faster. Apparently, big fail. 2 hours, beautiful. 7.5 hours, junk. You decide. Can I make anything because I have a CNC machine? See you in the next video.